lecture, we have seen about the capital structure phase. What do you mean by capital structure? Capital structure means firm's pattern of raising long-term sources of funds. Company need long-term funds, and for that, they raise the fund from the various sources: equity shares, preference shares, debenture, bank term loan, accumulated reserve. That in together is known as capital structure. Capital, word capital means long-term. So, in the corporate finance, the finance manager has to take three major decisions regarding financing, whether to finance the project with the long-term sources or short-term sources, what should be the combination, how much amount is to be provided for the working capital. If the company need to finance the long-term fund, then it should be from issue of equity shares, preference shares, reserve surplus, debentures. Lot of decisions they have to take regarding the working capital finance. The decision may be regarding whether it needs to be financed through the supplier credit or maybe the bank overdraft, bill discounting, different things are there. Another is, after financing, the very important is the investment decision. Whether to invest in long-term activities or short-term, how much amount needs to be invested for the long-term activities, and capital budgeting is that all we have already seen in the graduation study, as well as the same topic is there in your semester 4 in a financial management. So we will discuss later on means regarding the investment decision. And the third very important decision in the corporate finance is the dividend decision. Now what is the meaning of dividend? Dividend is not expenses. Dividend is not the regular commitment of the expenses. It is nothing but the distribution of profit. See, the shareholders get annual return in the form of dividend. And equity shareholders are the residual earners. Already I explained in the capital structure saying that the return available to the investors is earning before interest and tax. Earning before interest and tax. And the first commitment is interest. Thereafter, you have to pay the government government portion, that is the tax, which is payable as per the prevailing rate of tax. And thereafter, preference dividend, and afterwards, after transferring the necessary amount to various reserves, company distributes the dividend. So it is up to the company how much amount is to be distributed, but lot of factors are there which influence the dividend policy of the company. Means the profitability earned during the year, the past trend of dividend, competitors' dividend policy, government regulations. Now, recently, the Income Tax Department has made eliminated the dividend distribution tax, and now the shareholders will have to pay tax on dividend. Earlier, it was exempt. Under Section 10, they took the dividend from the on the shares of the Indian companies were exempt, but now it is taxable. So different things are there which influence the dividend policy. Now the corporate need not to pay dividend distribution tax, they may pay maximum dividend to their shareholders. It also depends on the liquidity position of the company, working capital availability. Lot of factors are there. But for the and definitely the dividend policy affects on the market value of the company. So therefore, the company needs to implement the regular and stabilized dividend policy. Different dividend policies are there that we will discuss. But before that, we have to keep in mind some theories which are available for the dividend distribution. So Walter model is there, which suggests that maximum dividend is to be distributed if company's return is less than the expected or market return. The Gordon growth model is also there. The Gordon model suggests that if the company's growth rate is less than the market rate, then they should distribute maximum dividend, and vice versa case. The MM approach is there, where they suggest that no, dividend policy is not relevant for the maximization of the wealth of the shareholders. And thereafter, some other dividend policies are there. Stable dividend policy. Its company should pay the stable rate of dividend. They should not pay very high volume of dividend. They should pay the dividend, but at the regular level. Means in future also they have, if any contingency arises, they have to protect that contingency with adequate provision in dividend equalization reserve. Other companies may follow the residual dividend policy. Means after deducting the regular commitment, compulsory commitment, that is in the form of interest, tax, preference dividend, and after transferring appropriate profit to the various reserves, whatever amount left, that should be distributed to the shareholder. Some other dividend policies also there, which suggest that the fixed percentage on earning per share means the dividend payout ratio. For example, whatever amount is earned for the equity shareholder, known as earning per share, 50% or 40% regularly should be distributed. Some suggest that the distribution should not be varying every year, so it should be fixed on the face value of share. For example, 15% or 14% or 13% or 50% or 100%, whatever. Some theories are there where the company pays fixed percentage of payout ratio plus some additional portion of dividend, which is also called as extra dividend. So, if the company has good profit, they may pay extra dividend. Depends. As you know that the dividend is distributed in two forms, majorly. That is the revenue dividend and capital dividend. Revenue dividend also called as cash dividend, where the shareholder gets a particular amount of cash that will be credited to their bank account. It is further divided between two categories, regular or annual dividend and interim dividend. The dividend which is paid at the end of every year, that is called the annual dividend. Interim dividend means dividend paid between two annual dividends, that is called the interim dividend. Interim dividend is normally paid when company earns good profit within a year, and for example, if they have paid less dividend in the previous year, they may pay interim dividend. They will not pay until the closure of the current financial year. Before that, they may pay interim dividend. But lot of procedure is there. They have to take SEBI permission. Lot of complexities are there. That is not a part of this today's discussion. The another is the capital dividend, means the bonus share. So, for example, if company is having good profit which is accumulated in the business, and if they want to execute a new project, they may use that completely internal financing, that is a form of reserve and surplus, and for that they may issue bonus shares. So bonus shares means shares issued to the equity shareholder without charging any amount. So that means a free shares. Now you have to read some part from regarding the dividend from our textbook. But I will solve 2-3 questions on the Gordon model and Walton model. So if question comes in the exam, it may come on Gordon model or Walton model. So first of all, we will discuss the Walton model. Now what Walton suggested? Professor James C. Walton. See, his theory suggests that if the company's internal rate of return, means whatever company earns on its employed capital, if it is less than the market return, company should pay maximum dividend. In vice versa case, company should pay less dividend. If the market rate of return and company's rate of return same, then there is no problem. You can pay less dividend or more dividend, no problem. Now, his theory suggests that if company pays maximum dividend when company's internal rate of return is less, it will help to boost the market price of their share. On the other hand, if the market price, market expectation or market rate is less than the internal rate of return, they should not pay maximum dividend. That means they should retain good profit in the business. Why? Because the company is having good prospect. The company is having good prospect. And definitely they will increase the value of the shares much ahead as compared to the other companies in the industry. So for example, if MRF Limited internal rate of return, say for example 20%, and the market rate is 15%, then in this case MRF should not pay maximum dividend. they should retain more and more profit in the business. Why? Because their shareholder prospect is good. In future, the company's growth is not very high. So therefore, their company can think about the Walter model. Some regulations are there, some assumptions are there. Walter model thinks that all finance is through the internal way, that means through the accumulated profit, and whenever the need arises, the fund may be obtained. Yes. Obtained through the reserve and surplus. The 100% payout ratio, that is also one of the assumptions. So some assumptions are there, but that we will not go in deep. We have to just follow this formula, and I have written the abbreviation for this short form used in the formula. So students, P means market price of share. So if you have to find out the market price of share, what is the formula on the basis of dividend distribution? So here P means, yes, market price of the share. D means dividend per share. Yes, E means earning per share. As you know that D again comes, D means dividend per share. R means return on investment, company's internal rate of return or return on employed capital. K means cost of equity. Okay, that is an expected cost by the shareholder. Again, that's a basic term. So, yes. I will take question number 23. Question number 23 suggests that following are the details regarding two companies, A Limited and B Limited. Internal rate of return given, cost of equity capital given, earning per share given. Calculate the value of an equity share of each of these companies according to Walter's model, where dividend payout ratio is 75%. So what is the meaning of dividend payout ratio? Very simple. Earning per share into payout ratio. Your company has 4 rupees. In this case, 75% payout means there will be 3 rupees dividend, 1 rupees they will retain in the business. Okay. Now, what should be each company's strategy to maximize the market value of its shares? So, this question recently came in the last session, May 2019. So, very fresh question. So, usually you may ask such type of question in your examination, you have to get ready. This topic, they have merged in capital structure things. There is no specific chapter for them, but they have merged this chapter with the capital structure things. So it is possible that they may ask 8 marks question on capital structure and 7 marks on dividend. Depends. So I will solve first about the A Limited and then I will go for the B Limited. Now A Limited. Yes, P. P means value of the share. Now, earning per share was 8 rupees and as said that payout ratio is 75%. 8 ka 75% is how much? 6 rupees. I can write down here dividend payout ratio. Yes, 8 into 75% is so dividend will be 6 rupees. 6 plus E means earning per share. 8 minus 6 into R means rate of return. So internal rate of return is 15%, 0.15. 15% is 0.15. And cost of equity is 10%, 0.10. Divided by 0.10, that is cost of equity. If you solve this formula, the value will come 19 rupees. I'll explain what happened. If we go to the B Limited, what will happen? B Limited, value of the share, yes. Their earning is also 8 rupees per share, but their internal rate of return is less than the cost of capital. See the difference between the A Limited and B Limited. I will explain you in detail. First, we will focus on the B Limited valuation of share on the basis of dividend distribution according to the Walter model. Now, earning dividend is 6, earning 8 minus 6, yes. Cost of capital, internal rate of return is 0.05% in 0.05 absolute form, divided by, yes, 10% is 0.10, divided by 0.05. reason why. Students, their indicated internal rate of return is 15%, which is more than the cost of capital. So their IRR is more than the cost of capital. On the other hand, B indicated IRR is less than the cost of capital. How? 5% and here 10%. What Walters suggests that if the company's internal rate of return is more, they should pay less dividend. Kitna dividend kam karte jayenge, utna hi value badhte jayenge. And if the company's internal rate of return is less, they should pay more dividend. Kitna dividend badhaya jayega, utna uska value badhte jayenge. You can calculate. Instead of 6, you can take 8 rupees. Agar, or instead of 6, you can take 2 rupees. Dekho, value kaise change hoga. It is not presented in the book, but I will explain. Okay? Now see, for example, iska internal rate of return jyada hai. Means the dividend kam diya, to iska value badhega. Aur iska internal rate of return kam hai. To inhone dividend jyada diya, to iska value badhega. Dekhna hai, check karte hain. 6 ki jagah pe hum log aisa sochte 2 rupaye means 75% ki jagah pe 25% kam dividend kyun IRR jyada hai kya hoga 2 8 minus 2 ab dekho kya hoga ye ho gaya 6 barabar hai yes 6 6 plus 2 8 correct Yes, ये हो गया 8. 0.15 divided by 0.8. How much? You can calculate. It will come around 1.5. So 8 into 1.5. It will come 12. So यहाँ हमें 12. Divided by 0.8. Its price is now again 20. Then कितना था? 9. अभी कितना हो गया? 1.8. क्यों? Dividend कम किया. और dividend कम किया तो और value बढ़ते हैं. यहाँ देखते हैं. They should pay maximum dividend. Say for example, 6 is, so we have 8 rupees. So we have 8 rupees. So here answer we have 8. Okay, 0.05 into 0.8. So 0.05 into 0.8 is here again 0.5. 0.5 play on the 4.
Now,
Now, we will solve one problem on border problem. Question number 27, page number 255. Question number 27, page number 255. Profit before tax is 2 crore 50 lakhs. Tax rate 40%. Retention ratio 40% means 60% is a payout ratio. Number of outstanding shares 50 lakhs. Equity capitalization rate is 12%. And return rate of return on investment is 15%. Now in this case we have to find out the present value of market price per share. Now students, first of all in earning that we have to calculate. So our profit before tax is 2 crore 50 lakhs. 2 crore 50 lakhs. Interest is already paid. Interest is already paid. 2 crore 50 lakhs. Earning before tax. Less tax at the rate 30%. Means how much? Yes. Sorry, 40% tax rate. So 1 crore rupees. Means profit after tax or earning after tax is 1 crore 50 lakhs. Now number of equity shares. 50 lakhs. Earning per share is nothing but what? Earning after tax divided by number of equity shares. So answer will come rupees 3. So E is equal to continue. E is equal to 3. Yes. 1 minus B. B means retention ratio. And the retention ratio is 40%. So payout ratio is 60%. Next. K means cost of capital. So equity capitalization rate is given in this problem, which is 12%. And rate of return on investment is also given 15%. Now student, the rate of return on investment is 15% and 12% is given equity capitalization.
Clear?
Thank you.